Welcome to another Sunday morning conversation, everybody. Today, my guest is Catherine Hollister. She is the owner and operator of Blue Sky Endurance, which is a tri shop out in Charleston, South Carolina. It's actually Mount Pleasant, but it's all the same area. She has two stores, and we're going to talk about it and her ties to triathlon. So thanks for tuning in, everybody.
Hey, Eric.
Hey, how are you?
I'm doing well. How are you?
Another day in the life.
Great.
I see you've got your wall of shoes behind you.
Yeah. Yes, I'm just in the back room of the shop. Is that all right?
Oh, doesn't matter. It's perfectly fine.
Okay, great.
Oh, I blanked on what I was going to say. How big is your shop? I mean, yeah, on your website, it says you have two stores?
We do. Mm-hmm. We've got one on Coleman Boulevard. Are you familiar with Mount Pleasant already?
I've been there a couple of times, but that's about it.
Yeah. So Coleman Boulevard, our shop is about a mile down from Shem Creek. Do you know where Shem Creek is?
I can't remember.
No. It's coming off the bridge. If you're heading to Sullivan's Island, we're about halfway down to Sullivan's Island on the right-hand side. And then we opened another shop up in North Mount Pleasant, which is just a completely different zip code. And it's 9.67 miles away, but it's more of like a 20 to 30 minute drive, depending on traffic.
You know how the bridge is named Wonders Way?
Yes.
I went to high school. Well, Garrett Wonders went to the same high school as I did.
Really?
We both swam.
Oh, okay. Where did you go to high school?
Warren G. Harding up in Ohio.
Oh, wow. I didn't know that.
Yeah.
I didn't know that's what Wonders Way was named after.
Yeah, he was a good cyclist. He did some triathlon stuff early on, but it's weird because we're 7 years apart, but we kind of follow the similar path.
Mm-hmm.
He was going to go the pro cycling road, and our lives kind of I kind of aligned in the same ways. I'm like, wow. I talked to him because he got killed in an accident. That's why I got named after him.
And okay.
I talked to his wife or his former wife, and we had a long conversation. I'm like, wow, you know, every detail about our lives. He married his high school sweetheart. I did, but she was a majorette, and like, so was mine. I'm like, wow, this is so eerie. So,
wow.
And then I came in the first time I had learned about Wonders Way is I came and ran the Cooper River Bridge Run in 2017. It's a fantastic run.
It is. That is a favorite of a lot of people here locally.
Well, I would say if it's local, you might as well do it. It's kind of like the Peachtree Road Race down here.
Yes. Yes. I have yet to do that. I need to get there to do it.
Come and join 60,000 of all our nearest and dearest friends.
Yeah. Sounds like fun.
Give me 1 second. I got to plug my battery charger in. I saw it flash.
Okay.
Ugh. There we go. So tell me, what made you want to start a tri shop?
Because there wasn't one in Charleston anymore. I worked for Tri Sports back when it was in business, and it had a very slow decline and then went out of business. And then I just found that there was a big void in the market and it was something I wanted to fill. So that's how it came to be.
Oh, that's relatively simple.
Mm-hmm.
What kind of following do you have? Do you have like a team for your store?
So we do. I mean, we have, for example, on Sunday, we're competing as a team at the local sprint triathlon on James Island. But we don't have, it's not a team, say, that's exclusive. It's anybody who wants to be on the team. It's very open. Whoever wants to train with us can train with us. It's not something that's exclusive or that you have to be fast or a certain caliber of athlete to be on our team. So I would say we're much more of a community than we are a team. So, and then to answer your question about who our customer is, it's, you know, when I opened, I probably thought it was going to be triathletes, but triathletes are actually a very small percentage of our customer base. We have everything for swimming, biking, and running. So we service the pure swimmer, the pure cyclist, and the pure runner, and then some triathletes, if that makes sense.
It does. Mm-hmm. We have two tri shops here in Atlanta, All Three Sports and Podium Multisport. They're owned by the same guy.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know if you're familiar with his name, Matt Cole.
Yeah, I'm familiar with the businesses.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I race for all three sports. So they operate much the same way you do, but more or less, they sell less running shoes and they're mm-hmm. more of the swim and bike side.
Yes. Yeah. We're pretty heavily focused on run, but we have a really strong bike services business. So, and then a really strong swim business as well.
What kind of bike stuff do you carry? What bikes do you carry? What's your brands?
We have Cervelo, Cannondale, Parley, and some Felt. Felt's been the slowest to come back since COVID, but those are the main brands. And then we also carry some lifestyle bikes, especially up at our second location. And that's a Retrospec is the brand that we carry for their hybrids and their cruisers.
You can't go wrong with Cervelo. It's the top selling bike.
Yeah, when you can get them. Yes, it's been hard since COVID to get what you want.
I have one. I have a P5. So nice. I bought it at a dry shop.
Nice.
So tell me about, since you are on the ocean, tell me about your swim line and everything. You obviously probably sell a lot of wetsuits. And you must do better with your swim stuff there than like something further inland.
Yeah, you know, our swim business is mainly around our summer swim teams and our high school teams. So we have a big summer swim league here in Charleston. So we outfit a good number of them with their swimsuits and their caps and goggles, t-shirts and all that, all of their gear. So that's a big piece of business for us. Then we also do some high school teams locally as well. We started out selling wetsuits, but then I switched to just renting a wetsuit. I found that a person purchasing a wetsuit, it can really vary between somebody who just doesn't want to spend a lot of money to the person who wants the really high-end wetsuit. So we rent the wetsuits, and then you can put your rental fee towards the purchase of a suit, and we'll special order the suit based on what they're looking for in their wetsuit.
That's nice. I mean, especially if you're like only using it just for one race.
Right. So in 90 days to put their rental fee towards the purchase, and it's the Blue 70 brand. So it's going to fit the same way as their rental, but then they can put it into, you know, a Helix or whatever, something high end if they prefer, or just the bottom line entry level wetsuit.
Do you have a lot of sponsorship with local races?
Yes, we do. We do a lot of sponsorship for the sprint series, the triathlon series, the Kiowa triathlon, and then some road races. And then we also do our own races as well that we put on.
Okay. Now, mm-hmm. do you have any like ties to the Cooper River Bridge Run? Since that's really the biggest race I know in the area.
Yeah. Well, our Sean Coleman Boulevard is right near the start line. So we have our shop open at 6 a.m. and for anybody that's in the corral right in front of the shop, we have giveaways that we toss over the fences. And if you're wearing anything that says Blue Sky Endurance, you can get to the front of the bathroom line in the store that morning. So that's mainly how we participate. The Cooper River Bridge Run is pretty big corporate sponsorship dollars. And we truly are just a small local business. So we don't have the thousands, $10,000 sponsorship that it would require to sponsor the Bridge Run.
Yeah, that's cool. That's definitely neat that if you're wearing your store gear, you get to the front of the line. Yeah. I've never heard anything do anything like that before.
Yeah, we even have bathroom bouncers. So they make sure that if you've got it on, you get to they pull you up to the front.
That's awesome.
Yeah.
Do you know who Jeremy Davis is? He runs the South Carolina Tri-Series.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
Do you have anything to do with this Edisto Beach Half Ironman? He just launched it last year.
Yes, we ran a volunteer water station out there last year. It's just as part of a sponsorship to help support the race. But it sounds like this year they've improved the bike course. I think there was quite a few turns on the last bike course. So it sounds like this year is going to be much better. But he had a pretty good turnout, I think, for his first year. So I think he'll do even better this year with it. And we hope to be involved with it again for sure.
Yeah, I did his last 2019 when he had the Oconee Man up in Northwest, South, Northwest South Carolina. Huh? He had a Coney man. I did that, and it only had like an 80-person turnout. But he couldn't keep the race alive because it was so hilly that nobody wanted to do it. I'm like, oh, I thought that was the fun part.
Yeah. If you live in the low country, it's really hard to train for hills. I think we tend to shy away from hilly courses for sure.
I mean, all you really have is that bridge to do hill repeats on.
I know. But a good bike trainer, a good smart trainer can take care of that. I always tell people.
Yeah. You know, those kickers definitely make a difference. I usually ride mine after my accident, so I stay indoors.
Yeah, me too. I'm primarily indoor trainer. Yeah,
it's just so convenient too, and it's like I don't have to go, I don't have to drive anywhere, unload, get dressed, all that stuff. I just hop on and go.
It's a huge time saver. Yeah.
Do you sell kickers too? I'm assuming you have to.
We do. Mm-hmm.
What are your sales like on those? Do they sell a lot of them in volume, or are they kind of just trickle stuff?
You know, when we first started carrying them, when they first came out, which was about 6 years ago, we sold a lot of them because they were very new to the market. Now you can get refurbished kickers. They have a really strong direct-to-consumer program as well. So we do sell them, but not as robustly as we did when they first came out.
Oh, okay.
Mm-hmm.
So tell me, do you have plans on, because you're in Mount Pleasant, do you plan on expanding into Charleston, or is just two shops kind of where your limit's at?
Well, we just opened the second shop in March, so it's probably a little too soon for me to answer that question. I'm still trying to catch my breath opening this second shop. I mean, I think ideally we'd like to expand to another location. I'm not totally sure where that is. For the longest time, I really thought it was going to be West Ashley. But then the more time I spent in North Mount Pleasant and the traffic in Mount Pleasant, if I lived in North Mount Pleasant, I wouldn't drive to our Coleman location either, which was the main reason why we opened this. It's much smaller than our Coleman store. This is almost like a satellite location up here. But with there's so much growth up in North Mount Pleasant, and it's just going to continue, we thought this would be a better place to plant our second location, and then maybe our third location, maybe West Ashley, but it might be someplace I haven't thought of similar to North Mount Pleasant. It might just dawn on me that, you know what, this is where we need to be next. And, or maybe not, maybe we'll just be fine with two locations. We'll see. It's kind of too soon to say. Yeah, I always say it's like after having a baby, like you can't ask somebody, you're gonna have another one. You can't ask them that right away. Not till the baby's sleeping through the night, you know, you can't ask that question.
Yeah. What kind of people do you have working at your store? Are they a bunch of part-time triathletes, retirees? What's the demographic you got working for you?
We have a really diverse demographic of people that work at Blue Sky. So we've got high schoolers that run cross country. We've got college kids that love triathlon. I've got moms that have kids in school, but they either are triathletes or they love to run or they just love fitness. And then probably my favorite demographic are the semi-retired folks because they're looking to do something that's more of their passion and their hobby. And they have a great work ethic and they're so reliable and they have great ideas and they love to share them. And so I learned a lot from them. So I have three semi-retired people on our staff. And one of them is our bike mechanic, who's pure genius. He's fantastic. It's just a really diverse, it's not all triathletes by any means, although we do have some great ones on staff too.
Oh, the semi-retired ones are great. I mean, I know the local run shop down the street from me, they've got a bunch of semi-retired people. It's like, oh, they have great availability and they're kind of bored. So,
yeah, it's great.
So tell me, how did you come up with Blue Sky Endurance as your name? What was your reasoning behind that?
I would say the main reason behind the name I chose is it wasn't taken. You have to be really careful about things that you choose and domain names and what's available. So I wanted something that rhymed with triathlon. So then we came up with Sky, Tri, Then we came up with, I forget how we came up with the blue part, blue sky, but then I decided I didn't want the word triathlon in the name of the store because I didn't want to pigeonhole us into only doing triathlons. So if we show up to a trail race or a track meet, it's not going to be like, well, why is there a tri shop here? Does that make sense? I knew that I wanted to be more diverse, and we are ending up being much more diverse than just a tri shop.
Yeah, so, by not labeling yourself, you open yourself up to more markets.
Right. Yeah. And it wasn't taken. So.
Yeah, that's definitely a good approach. I mean, because I know the tri shops that I've seen, like Podium and All Three Sports, they kind of do pigeonhole themselves because, you know, All Three Sports is naturally all three, but they definitely attract more triathletes than they do so, like solo sports. Trying to think of how I want to phrase that, more than, you know, people who do just swim, bike, or run.
Yeah.
So
we also, I mean, we get people that come in just for lifestyle shoes, just general fitness. So I would have someone to look at the name of the shop and like, oh, that I can't go in there because I'm not a triathlete, you know?
Yeah, I totally get that.
Yeah.
So to get here, I'm going to get you out on this one. What do you want to do with your store in the future? What are your short-term and long-term goals?
Short-term, I just want to keep building the brand awareness of who we are and what we do. And long-term, I just would love it to be a long-lasting brand that's around for a long, long time. That it's not just a flash in the pan.
That's awesome. I'll have to stop by and pay a visit because I'm going to do that either this year or next year. I'm going to do Jeremy's triathlon at Edisto Beach.
Yes, definitely. You should.
I have a friend from back home who moved to Mount Pleasant somewhere. She was in West Ashley and now she's in Mount Pleasant. She's a chiropractor.
Okay. Yeah, it sounds like you have a couple good reasons to come.
Well, that and it's Charleston. I just like the city too. Like Savannah, it's one of those cities that you can't hate.
That's right. I agree.
Well, hey, thanks for joining me today. I appreciate
it. Yeah. Thanks for having me. I really appreciate your time.
All right. Take it easy. I'll see you soon.
All right. Bye-bye.